Back again, we're gonna shift back to the chocolate chip cookie dough, but I'm gonna throw in a twist and bring in the rest of my peanut butter marshmallow I have, because now my tub is looking a little empty, but that's okay because there's many recipes to keep coming along. What we are gonna be making today, in conjunction with the My Oatmeal, I love the oatmeal, also the PB Lean, which is a PB2 kind of replacement, we're gonna be making no bake oatmeal balls. So we're going to be taking the chocolate chip cookie dough, peanut butter marshmallow, some oatmeal, and making some peanut butter chocolate chip cookie dough oatmeal balls. Very quick on prep time, not a lot of ingredients, and this is something that you can store in the fridge, store in the freezer, very easy on the go snack. Okay? So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to take about a little bit over a half a scoop, about 3/4 of each, 25 grams of the chocolate chip cookie dough, 25 grams of the peanut butter marshmallow. You're gonna take 1 cup of oatmeal, and you can blend it in a bowl, like a magic bullet or a blender, to make it a fine powder, or you can use it straight up as is, as it comes in myoatmeal.com. And I'm gonna use the cookie dough flavor to complement the chocolate chip cookie dough Core Performance Whey, okay? PB2, or you can use the PB Lean, which I think is superior in taste. I have the peanut butter flavor here, but Anthony does have a cookie dough flavor, as well as over billions of combinations. So, simple for your dry. I also added a little bit of Splenda, 3 grams like I normally do, to help with the overall flavoring. If you want to add more PB2, sugar-free factory's yellow pudding mix, by all means, that's totally up to you guys, okay? Dry ingredients, very simple. The last one I will add is peanut butter chips, or you can use chocolate chips. I'm going to use the Reese's. Why? Because it's going to complement all these flavors and make these things taste delicious. Okay, wet ingredient wise, all right, not really anything really that wet. I took a touch over of a tablespoon of peanut butter, put it in a bowl. I took 1 tablespoon of honey, put it on top of that in the bowl. Then I took a banana and mashed it up to make it like kind of like a fat replacement, like a Greek yogurt or an applesauce. And I combined all those things in this bowl right here, okay? So that is my wet, the peanut butter, the mashed banana, and the honey. So you're just gonna mix it up like you see here, and you're gonna add it to the dry. Next thing you're gonna do, take the spoon, mix it up, and that's it. Then all you're gonna do is take some parchment paper or wax paper, and once I mix this up, I'll cut the camera and come back. We're just gonna drop little spoonfuls to make balls. And again, you put it in the fridge, they'll harden up. Or you can make these into protein bars and pack them down on the tin foil and take them with you on the go. 10 to 15 minutes, they harden straight up, or you can freeze them for a later date. So let me mix this up, we'll show you the final. When everything's mixed up, it should be stick to your spoon thick like that, okay? So what you're gonna do is just take a little tablespoon, okay? And you can take it in your hand, roll it into a little ball, okay? Place it right there on the parchment paper. And you're just gonna repeat the process for the rest of it. And like I said, you're just gonna put it in the fridge and these things will harden up. They look a little gooey and a little soft, but that's how it should be. Because once you let these sit in the fridge and let them finalize, they come out fantastic, okay? Any questions, comments, concerns, check the comment box below. It has all the recipe. It has the directions, ingredients, macronutrients. Also, links to myoatmeal.com, cellucor.com. Pick up the exclusive chocolate chip cookie dough, which you cannot find in stores, only in the 3-letter store. But also, a great discount, BCOOP20, to help with ordering your supplements and getting everything you need. So I'm going to finish this off, put these in the fridge, and guys, another great recipe that you should give a swirl. Thanks again.